All right, gonna do a video debunking Catholic Answers and their video they did about verses supposedly proving work salvation in this current dispensation. Of course, Catholics are non-dispensational, so they'll go to verses in the Old Testament, they'll go to verses in the future time of Jacob's trouble and apply it to today. And that's what they do in this video. They go to verses that are not even speaking to Christians, are not even dispensationally for us, and apply it to us today. You're going to see that in this video. They go to the book of James, classic for all Catholics. They go to the book of Matthew, where Jesus is talking about the end of the time of Jacob's trouble. They go to the book of Matthew, where Jesus is talking about the kingdom of heaven and all this other stuff. I mean, again, non-dispensational. They do not rightly divide the word of truth. But let's get right into it. Here's the first clip.
Years ago, number one, Mary, is you want to bring out James chapter 2, verse 24, and put it just as James says it. We see that a man is justified by works and not by faith alone. And ask him the question, what would the Bible have to say to get you to believe that it's more than just faith?
Exactly. We're going to hit those other four.
Okay, we'll get the other four after the break. But James 2:24, we see that a man is justified by works and not by faith alone.
All right, typical for Catholics to run to James 2:24. It's their go-to verse. They always love to run to prove work salvation. I've written in my notes that James 2:24 is not even dispensationally for us. It's in the time of Jacob's trouble. And in fact, the book of James is not even written to Christians. It's written to Jews. If you read James chapter 1, verse number 1, the very first verse in the book of James, he says that he's sent to the 12 tribes of Israel. That's what the book of James is written to. So it's not even written to us. So to take that and apply it to us is ridiculous. That's, you know, you're supposed to rightly divide the word of truth. So again, proving they're non-dispensational. On to the next clip.
How? Mary in Houston was there. Mary, you still there?
You still there, Mary?
Mary in Houston.
I am, yeah.
Okay, right. Great. So your Baptist father-in-law was teaching justification by faith alone, and Tim was cranking through five biblical passages that totally contradict. The first one was James chapter 2.
2 verse 24. Yeah. But, and I want to warn you, Mary, that the response will be, well, James is not actually talking about works justifying, but works proving that someone already is justified. But what you do when you say that is, no, you just said that. That's not what James says. Mm-hmm. James says, we see that a man is justified by works and not by faith alone. So in some sense, you have to say our justification our works are included in the process of justification. So that's number one. Number two, you want to show, not just in James, but in books like Galatians and Romans, which are the ones that Luther classically used, you know, Romans 3:28, a man is justified by faith apart from the works of law. They love to use that text and some from Galatians, like Galatians 2:16 as well. So what you do, now, those were not the ones I wanted to give you. Here's the ones I want to give you. Romans chapter 2, verses 6 and 7. All right, notice this. St. Paul says, God will reward each man according to his works. To him who continues in good works, his reward shall be glory, incorruption, and eternal life. So notice, eternal life is a reward for good works. Now, of course, those works have to be done in Jesus, through Jesus, but we must do them.
Okay, read the context of Romans chapter 2, verse 5 to 7. It's talking about God's righteous judgment on the wicked. It's not talking about earning your salvation by works. Again, read the context. These Catholics, you're going to see over and over again, they don't read the context. They take stuff out of context. So again, on to the next clip.
That's number two. Number three, you go to Galatians chapter 6, verses 7 through 9. Where St. Paul says, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man sows, that shall he reap. Now, sows, meaning, you know, you, like the farmer who goes out and sows seeds. This is something you have to do, right? To him who continues to sow to the flesh, he shall of the flesh reap death. But for him who continues to sow to the Spirit, he shall of the Spirit reap everlasting life. Let us not, therefore, grow weary in well-doing, for we shall reap if we faint not. Now, that's verse 9. So you want to do Galatians 6, verses 7 through 9. And you say, well, how can Paul be any more plain that we have to continue to do good works and our reward will be eternal life?
Again, read the context of Galatians chapter 6, verse 7 to 9. I have written in my notes that the context is about bearing another one's burdens, not talking about earning your salvation by works. And I also have written in my notes that sowing to the flesh will make you lose rewards, but sowing to the Spirit will actually get you rewards in heaven and everlasting life. That's what it's talking about. It's not talking about earning your salvation. So again, failure to rightly divide and also failure to just read the context of the passage.
Number four, you want to go to Matthew chapter 12, verses 36 and 37. And I include 36 because in verse 36, our Lord is talking about the final judgment. And then in verse 37, he says, by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned.
And again, what's the context of Matthew chapter 12, verse 36 to 37? He's talking about the millennial kingdom. He mentions the kingdom of God. He's not talking about earning your salvation by works in the church age, this current dispensation. Again, read the context of the passage. He's talking about the millennial kingdom. Because during the 1,000-year reign of Christ, salvation is by works. You can't have faith because Christ is there physically ruling on the earth. So how do you have faith if he's there physically ruling? You can't. It's by works in the 1,000-year reign of Christ. So in the context of the passage, he's talking about the 1,000-year reign of Christ. Again, just read the context of the passage.
And then finally, you want Matthew 25, verses 31 through 46. And this is the scene of the final judgment, where Jesus separates the sheep and the goats. I'm not going to read through the whole thing, but the bottom line is what you read in that story of the final judgment is the only difference between the sheep and the goats is what they did and did not do. They all call Jesus Lord, but the difference is what they did and did not do. Those are five examples I could give you. 25, but that should get you started. And I would also encourage you to get a hold of Jimmy Akin's new book called The Drama of Salvation.
And they go to Matthew 25, which is talking about the judgment after the time of Jacob's trouble, separating the saved from the lost. It's not talking about salvation in this current dispensation. It's talking about salvation, or talking about the judgment seat after the time of Jacob's trouble, because during the time of Jacob's trouble, salvation is again by works. Because you can't take the mark of the beast. If any man takes that mark, they get God's wrath, according to Revelation 14. So you have to refuse to take that mark of the beast. And also Revelation 14, verse 12 says, here are the patience of here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. You have to keep the commandments and the faith of Jesus. Faith and works. So the context of Matthew 25 is talking about the judgment after the time of Jacob's trouble. So he's not, I've written my notes here, Jesus was not even speaking to Christians in Matthew 25. He was speaking to Jews. Same thing in Matthew 24, the infamous post-trib passage. They'll say, it proves a post-trib rapture. Read the context. He's speaking to Jews. So this is my video refuting Catholic answers. People say, oh, no one can refute them. I just did. So if you're a Catholic out there, just know that Roman Catholicism is a pedophilic, satanic, pagan cult. It is not Christianity. It is a perversion of Christianity, rampant with pedophilia and sodomy and all this other disgusting stuff. So if you're a Catholic out there, get saved. Know that salvation in this current church age, or I like to call it the time of the Gentiles, that's the proper term, is by faith. You repent towards God, you put your faith in Jesus Christ, and in Romans 10:13 you call upon the name of the Lord. It's very, very simple. There's no works that are required. Ephesians 2:8-9 says, for by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Romans 4:5 says, but to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifieth the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. So if you're a Catholic out there, get saved. Know that you're in a pedophilic, satanic cult. Roman Catholicism, that's what it is. So anyway, God bless you. Goodbye.